The Dirt Challenge was an open challenge to the online poker community offered by high-stakes phenom Tom Dwan. This challenge was one of the most famous and most talked-of poker coups of all time. What could be pictured as the perfect marketing deal for Full Tilt Poker ultimately never fulfilled its potential and even damaged the reputation of one of the most famous online poker players of all time, Tom Dwan. At the time when online poker was at its ultimate high, Tom Dwan was the role model for every newcomer out there and one of the most popular advertisers for online poker. This was the time Full Tilt was still up and running and one of the big global players in online poker. These global players pushed poker into the mainstream with clever advertising, televised high-stakes cash games, and success stories of young rookies who made it. Even in the mainstream print media of the time, you could find frequent articles about the success and lifestyle of these new celebrities. It was the golden era of online poker, the fishes had fun, and the sharks were growing fat on easy bait, and it was this environment that would create one of the most controversial poker challenges ever openly announced. Tom Dwan, who dropped out of Boston University to pursue his poker career, had started with just $50 bankroll but moved up the rankings quickly. Because of his loose aggressive playstyle, his bankroll suffered massive swings which always were subject to controversial discussions not only by the professionals. It is well documented that in 2009, he lost about $7 million to Phil Ivey, Ilary Sahamias, and Victor Blom, causing rumors of his bankruptcy to quickly emerge. But Tom Dwan recovered from his downswing and more than made up for his losses just to suffer another massive downswing. But Dwan always seemed to get back up and come out with every money that he had lost. It was the ultimate poker rookie success story. He got beaten, sometimes with nearly career-ending losses, but somehow found a game where he won massive amounts of cash in very short time. In 2009, he had the reputation as one of the best PLO and No Limit Hold'em players in the world, and in January of 2009, Dwan announced to play anyone online heads up except of Phil Galfond and that he would enhance this challenge with an additional side bet worth as much as $1.5 million. Dwan and his opponent would have to play 50,000 hands, 4 tabling at 200-400 stakes or higher in No Limit Hold'em or Pot Limit Omaha. If either player dropped below 75 big blinds in their stack at any point, they must reload. At the conclusion of the Pot Limit Omaha or No Limit Hold'em hands, a winner will be crowned. If after the 50,000 hands, his opponent is ahead, Dwan would pay him an additional $1.5 million. If on the other hand, Dwan is ahead, his opponent would give him an additional $500,000.
It's 50,000 hands of 200, 400 or higher, no limit or PLO. I put up $1.5 million on the side to anyone's 500,000. And if you're up a dollar, you keep that. And if you're up a million, you keep the million plus the side bet. And I'm doing it just to try to create some action because I don't get people who win more than 2 tables heads up usually, and even 2 tables a lot of times not for too long. So got some action and hopefully it'll work out good.
Sadly, there was no time limit set to when the 50,000 hands would need to be completed. This little detail would become very controversial just a few months later. Nonetheless, with this kind of odds, any number of professional heads up players were lining up to play Tom Dwan. The first one to accept the challenge were Patrick Antonius, David Benjamin, and Phil Ivey. From these three, Antonius was the first one who actually played the first Dirt Challenge. The Finnish professional poker player agreed to play heads-up PLO with Dwan, which may have been a mistake as Dwan is known to be a better PLO player than No Limit Hold'em. The challenge progressed over the next year and was getting a lot of media attention, resulting in Tom Dwan being a member of Full Tilt team in November of 2009. In this part of the challenge, Dwan was firmly in control after 40,000 hands of the 50,000 hands to be played, and he was up by almost $2 million. The action died down gradually, and it was later announced that both players had settled the challenge privately, most likely with Antonius paying most of the $500,000 bet to Dwan on exchange for an early end of the challenge. 2009 was not all luck and profit for Tom Dwan, as there were rumors that he had lost some serious cash in No Limit Hold'em cash games against Luke Schwartz and much more prominent against Isildur One. His reputation as an expert No Limit Hold'em player was questioned at this time, but Dwan made up for his losses just a year later, winning over $9 million between December 2009 and April of 2010. Dwan made most of it in high variance PLO matches against players like Ilary Sahamias or Gus Hansen. Being firmly on top of his game, Dwan accepted the challenge of Daniel Jungleman Cates in 2010 as the second part of the Dirt Challenge. This time though, Tom Dwan had his hands full with his opponent. Daniel Cates decided to play No Limit Hold'em against Dwan, and it quickly became apparent that Cates had a considerable advantage over his opponent. After 19,355 hands, the game was stopped, Tom Dwan being at a disadvantage of more than $1 million. The more Dwan lost in this part of the challenge, the more difficult it became for Cates to get a hold of Dwan to continue playing. Dwan was clearly stalling the challenge, which might have something to do with him and Full Tilt parting ways in 2012. It is rumored that his sponsor Full Tilt would pay up a considerable chunk of the $1.5 million owed if Dwan loses his challenge, so Dwan had even more reason to abort his challenge. But although he was considered as outspoken and fairly straightforward by players and fans alike, Dwan never announced the end of the challenge, causing a lot of turmoil over the years. Years went by, and only 1,500 more hands were played in 2013 when Cates won a further $200,000. Now, almost 9 years later, this challenge against Cates is still not completed and has been called one of the biggest scams in poker by professional poker player Doug Polk. On the other hand, Daniel Cates himself always stood behind Tom Dwan and proclaimed on multiple occasions that the challenge will be completed at some point. Cates also explained that Dwan had some problems he needed to sort out and that he had paid as much as $800,000 as a fine for not being able to play the challenge. Why Tom Dwan is paying as much money as this and still not buying himself out of the challenge as Patrick Antonius did remains a mystery. But it's no secret that Tom Dwan's reputation has severely suffered from avoiding the challenge against Jungleman, so if he has the money, why not end it and salvage some of his reputation? This question fired up some more rumors about Tom Dwan being broke, but just as the last couple of times, the news of Tom Dwan's bankruptcy seemed to be greatly exaggerated. Jungleman outclassed Dwan in their clash, but both players seem to be at ease with each other. Jungleman is up almost $1.25 million after just 19,300 hands and has Dwan basically drawing dead, but yet both players cherish the idea of completing the challenge somewhere in the near future. However, if a post in 2+2 forums is to be believed, Dwan apparently forfeited the match according to Cates, also known online as Wookiees, in online chat with Finnish high stakes legend Ilarif Sahamias. Here is an excerpt from their chat. Neither Jungleman nor Dwan are the most communicative as far as social media goes, but there is no reason to disbelieve the online chat reported on 2+2. So it looks like fans will never see the Dirt Challenge completed, the only real question left being, how much will it cost Dwan to buy himself out of the match? Here are a few reasons why the Dirt Challenge may be dead for good. Number 1. Dwan is already losing and has little motivation to play. When activity in the challenge halted, Dwan was down almost $1.3 million after about 21,000 hands played. If Dwan loses, he'll have to pay Cates an extra $1.5 million. Given the current conditions, what motivation does Dwan have to finish this challenge? At best, a few hands will be played just to satisfy Cates. Number 2. Dwan no longer has a Full Tilt sponsorship. As of late 2013, Tom Dwan no longer draws big checks from Full Tilt Poker. In fact, Full Tilt, which once dominated the online high-stakes scene, has been absorbed by PokerStars. While we don't exactly know how much Dwan was being paid to represent Full Tilt, it's safe to assume that the amount was between $500 to $1 million per year. Without the money, he's less likely to have steady income to repay Cates in the event of a loss. Number 3. Cates is a far superior player. As if having a $1.2 million lead isn't already a big enough advantage, Cates is also a better online No Limit Hold'em player. After earning over $10.2 million through Full Tilt alone, Jungleman has continued sharpening his skills against top-ranked competition at PokerStars. Dwan, meanwhile, has been grinding in live games against a mix of businessmen, skilled amateurs, and pros. While this is enough to help Dwan remain a tough player, he's nowhere near a match for Cates these days. Number 4. Dwan gambled too much of his money away. One big reason why Dwan has avoided the challenge is because he put himself in the hole by gambling too much. As Cates puts it, Durr gambled beyond his means and is trying to resolve the situation. Number 5. Poker isn't as easy as it once was. Provided Dwan does lose, he'll okay $1.5 million plus any potential losses. Perhaps during his heyday from 2008-09, he could have recouped the money by dominating online regs. But those days are long gone, as evidenced by the fact that he has lost almost $6 million in 2010 and 11. What's bad is that the Macau games Duan plays in aren't the cash cow they once were, either because the businessmen are stronger players. Considering all of this, Duan knows that he can't win his money back so easily if when he loses to Cates. Number 6. Duan refuses to buy out of the challenge. The first ever dirt challenge between Tom Duan and Patrick Antonius ended with the latter buying out after quickly getting down to $1.85 million. Considering that Duan is down $1.2 million in the face-off with Cates and he doesn't have time to play the remaining 28,000 hands, he should have considered the buyout option at some point within the last 7 to 8 years. Given that Duan hasn't tried buying out at any time during his span, it seems that he either doesn't have the money or doesn't plan to honor the original deal. Number 7. Duan's reputation has already been damaged, why should he care now? Tom Duan was once revered in the poker community thanks to the fact that he spoke out about Full Tilt not repaying players after Black Friday. But aside from a few sessions in 2012 and 13, Duan has refused to sit down with Cates and finish their challenge. This has prompted both Cates and fellow high-stakes grinder Doug Polk to bash Duan for being a scammer. Any goodwill that he had earned for speaking on behalf of unpaid Full Tilt players has been tarnished over the past several years. Furthermore, he has been laying low in Asia and largely distant from the online poker world. Aside from being called out by a few players, why does he care about doing what's necessary to repay his reputation now? Let us know in the comments below on what you think Tom Duan should do at this point and whether you think the dirt challenge will be completed in the future. Also, if you like this video, leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.